Google has been working on Android 14 for the better part of a year now, and while we have yet to hear anything about its official release date, folks within the community have been digging through the developer preview and beta builds to reveal some new features that are coming. So today, I'll be covering the 10 most anticipated features coming to Android 15 later this year. First up, we have a redesigned volume panel. This new feature was first uncovered last month, and it just shows that we are likely to be moving away from the current design, which looks like this, and we will see an updated design that actually looks like this, and we will see an updated design that is sure to make it easier to adjust. Not having to pinpoint the dot in that tiny line is certainly going to help a lot. Next up, we have a partial screen sharing feature that will allow you to select only the app window itself while you are recording the screen. So instead of having details like your status bar and notifications coming in while you are recording the screen, this new Android 15 feature will only record the app that you want to share. Notification cooldown is another fantastic idea for a feature that has been spotted in the Android 15 betas. This works by allowing the operating system to monitor your notifications, and if it has detected a single app is sending you consecutive notifications, then it will apply a cooldown timer to that application or game. This can be a great way to lower the frequency of casual mobile games that just want to spam you notifications about timers, but it can also help to alleviate the stress from having a slew of alerts coming in from a group chat that you're following. Either way, reducing the number of trivial notifications is likely to make a major quality of life improvement to Android 15 later this year. Third-party apps may lose the ability to intercept SMS text, including two-factor authentication codes. There's been a rise in scams where malicious third-party apps are able to view text messages being sent to the device. This has allowed them to intercept those two-factor authentication codes and has resulted in some people losing access to their protected accounts. So within the code of an Android 14 beta, there's a new permission that has been discovered that will block third-party apps from accessing data within notifications that contain sensitive information. That, tied with a newly discovered platform feature, seems to indicate that Google is hoping to prevent this from happening in the near future. We have yet to see how this will be implemented, but since we've seen that Google has been working on the feature for a couple of years now, it could very well make its way into the public release of Android 15. Now, a feature that can be tried out and tested right now if you have a Google Pixel with the latest beta of Android 15 is a way to make your smartphone a high-quality webcam. This is an upgraded feature from Android 14 that it can improve the quality of your video stream at the expense of a little bit of heat generation. All you have to do is connect it to the PC with a USB cable, change the USB connection preference, and then you just need to tap on the HQ symbol in the top corner after the camera app has been launched. Private Spaces looks to be a new feature in development for Android 15 that allows you to hide individual applications on your smartphone or tablet so that they do not appear like normal. You could compare this to Samsung's Secure Folder feature, and it was also originally spotted in multiple beta releases of Android 14. When enabled, apps are added to a secret section that is only accessible after you bypass the lock screen that was specifically recreated for the private space feature, which is really handy as it could allow you to have two different pins, patterns, or passwords. One to unlock your phone like normal, and then one that gives you access to the private space feature. Emergency satellite messaging is another interesting feature that has been talked about the last couple of years. We've now seen that Android 15 has been improved to show these specific types of notifications, while also including status bar indicators for the feature as well. This new API will allow third-party SMS and MMS apps to send texts over a regular cellular network or a non-terrestrial network. Audio sharing capabilities has been spotted in the developer preview of Android 15, and it's said to allow you to share your audio stream with nearby people. We've seen this technology before with Auracast, but now it looks as if Android 15 will allow a basic form of this type of audio sharing in a user-friendly way. We'll just have to wait and see if the feature arrives in the stable release later this year. If an application is developed to target the Android 15 API, then that application will default to an edge-to-edge display mode. As shown in this example here, previously apps would be displayed like this, with the bottom bar, unless the developer went out of their way to correct it. Now, when apps are targeting the SDK 35, which is for Android 15, we now see the application user interface going all the way down to the bottom of the screen, as shown here. The last thing that I'll mention here today is Android 15 adding support for new camera hardware features. Naturally, these features will depend on the hardware actually supporting them, but so far we've seen added camera controls for low light enhancements and an advanced flash screen adjustment. The former will give apps the ability to boost the brightness of the preview of the image, while the latter will enable precise control of the LED flash strength when you capture that image. Now, all of the features mentioned here today have either been in development since last year with the Android 14 beta builds, or they are new this year with the early Android 15 updates. As we saw last year, though, some of these features may not make their way into the official stable release. But these are the top 10 features that I'm most excited about seeing in Android later this year. If you have a Google Pixel 6 or later, meaning any phone in the Pixel 6 series, Pixel 7 series, or the Pixel 8 series, and you're interested in testing out the Android 15 beta release, then check the video description below, as I'll have a link to a dedicated video that I have already done that shows you how to opt in to this Android beta program.